lovely readers, welcome to Living the Tales with me, Priyanka. I'm so excited to see you all. Are you ready for today's story? So this story teaches all the children that it is not always important to come first. What is important is to celebrate each other's successes and congratulate each other for trying their best. Come, let's read together Chuck the Cheetah, written by K.A. Malanga. If you have a copy, please go get it so you can read along with me. Chuck the Cheetah, written by K.A. Malanga, illustration by Sabita Yaya. Chuck was the fastest cheetah in the land. No one could beat him, no matter how hard they tried. So, it was assumed that at the daily friendly races, Chuck would win. And at the weekly fun races, Chuck would win. And at the monthly championship races, Chuck would win. No one could beat him. At the end of every race, which he always won, Chuck would jump up and twist his body in mid-air, singing cheerfully, "All I do is win, 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 win." The other cheetahs in Chuck's age group tried really hard to think up ways to beat him. One day, they met at the watering hole after one of the races.
"Chuck is just too good. How are we ever going to beat him?" sighed Chip.
"I know. No matter how hard we train, we always lose to Chuck," said Chum.
"I have an idea. Follow me,"
said Chester. Suddenly, Chip, Chum, and Chester saw Chuck. He was walking proudly through the grass.
"Hey, Chuck," called Chester cheerfully. "You are the fastest cheetah in the world. But what would happen if you lost a race? How would you feel?"
Chuck looked up at the three cheetahs.
"I never lose," he said, smugly.
"All I do is win, 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 win."
"But what if one day you did lose?"
asked Chip. Chuck looked up at the three cheetahs and said again proudly,
"I never lose. All I do is win, 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 win. No one could ever beat me," thought Chuck proudly.
"Chuck," said Chum, "everyone loves you, and I think even if you were to lose, people would still love you and respect you."
"But I never lose," yelled Chuck. "All I do is win, 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 win."
The next day, there was another daily friendly race. Chuck was so sure of winning that he told all the cheetahs that he would give them a 10-second head start. The race started, and Chum and Chip were in the lead. Although Chuck had started the race a whole 10 seconds later, very soon he was catching up to Chum and Chip. Just as they were nearing to the finish line and Chuck was racing to catch up with Chum and Chip, Chuck accidentally stepped on a thorn. He managed to kick the thorn out of his paw, but he was too late. He had lost his stride, and Chip had won the race. Chuck couldn't believe it. He walked away sadly as everyone else cheered for Chip and lifted him high up into the air. "Chip's the champ! Chip's the champ!" everyone screamed. Chuck didn't show his face at the races for the next few days. At the next weekly fun race, he showed up again.
"Listen, everyone, I'm still the fastest. I'm still the best," he boasted. "Chip was just lucky to win, because I had stepped on a thorn," he exclaimed.
And with that, off he went. All the cheetahs decided that they didn't like Chuck anymore because of his conceited nature. No one wanted to race with him or even play with him. That night, Chuck had a strange dream. In his dream, a wise old cheetah appeared before him. "You need to accept defeat and lose gracefully," the wise old cheetah told him.
"What does that mean?" asked Chuck.
"It means that even if you lose, you can still be happy for the winner. You win some, you lose some, whispered the wise old cheetah.
The next day, Chuck went to the daily friendly race and asked the others if he could join in the race. At first, the other cheetahs said no. He begged them to let him join in. Eventually, Chip, Chum, and Chester agreed to let him race against them. The race started, and as usual, Chuck was way ahead of everyone. Suddenly, just before the end, he started slowing down. This time, it was Chester who won the race. Chuck had let him win, but he didn't tell him he had done it on purpose. "Chester's the champ! Chester's the champ!" Everyone cheered. Chuck went up to Chester and said,
"Well done, that was a great race."
Chester was surprised. "But," he replied,
"I thought that all you do is win, 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 and that you never lose."
"Well, you win some, you lose some,"
said Chuck with a wink. And from that moment on, everyone loved Chuck again, just the way they used to. All the cheetahs played and raced together every single day again. And even though Chuck won most of the races, he never got upset when he lost one or two of them to his cheetah friends.